We in Austin can be proud of our beautiful residential districts, and the Nash Phillips Copus Company has contributed many of the fine homes in and around our area. Finer homes at lower cost. From start to finish, the company, Austin's leading realtor, takes care of the customers, giving them sound advice and trying to fit their picture of a dream house to their personal budget.
Okay, if anybody has one of these, I'll give them $100. If you have one of these, I'd love to have
The company architect meets with the customers to draw up tentative plans for the future residents. Surveyors get to work, starting the development of a plot of raw Texas land. Nash Phillips Copus owns hundreds and hundreds of acres of Austin land, showing their foresight and faith in our city's dynamic growth.
All right, does anyone know where this building used to be? Where? Fiesta. Awesome, I thought it was CVS. I was wrong. It's still a drugstore.
Bulldozers and graders take over from the surveyor, smoothing, grading, and leveling the land before the actual building can begin. Clyde Copus, Ed Stackley, the FHA inspector, and Charles Zunker, superintendent for the construction company, study the plans. Many of the major sections of the home are prefabricated before they reach the job site. Once the prospective homeowner brings his problems to Nash Phillips Copus, his worries are over. The company works in close conjunction with the best surveyors, engineers, and construction firms in Austin in order to produce more home for the money and quality at no extra cost.
All right, does anybody know this street? Does it look familiar? Can you name the intersection? Let me give you a second angle. I didn't get it, and I live on this street. Okay, does it look familiar now? It's Cameron Road and Cloverleaf. Look at all the trees. Look what 50 years does. You know where Cameron Road used to go? My hometown, Cameron, Texas.
Looks easy, doesn't it? With workmanlike precision and speed, the new home takes form. The roofers go to work, and there'll be no leaks in this roof, you can bet on that. Foolproof construction at reasonable prices make for satisfied homeowners.
Who paid for this? All right, this is 1953 outside the Delwood Pharmacy. There was no television in those days that most people had, so they would come show up at a pharmacy opening like this. All happy, wearing their nice clothes.
The asbestos siding is cut and then applied.
Nice.
Bricklayers and stonemasons on this job are real craftsmen as they put on the finishing touches. The marks of true styling on their work.
Whose house is that?
And of course, that all-important coat of paint goes on last, and with only a few minor adjustments left, the dream house has been completed.
They painted the whole house with brushes. Okay, Delwood Beauty Shop on Cameron Road.
Mr. Nash Phillips, himself the director of the National Association of Home Builders, displays the new home, filled with the most modern conveniences, to the proud couple, and indeed they may be proud.
Look at that, washing machine. Okay, anybody eat here? There we go, was it good?
Personalized supervision in the planning and construction of the home leads to future happiness and satisfaction. One specific example of more home for the money and quality at no extra cost.
Quality at no extra cost, that's our new motto at Winter Park Neighborhood Association, quality at no extra cost. Remember that next time somebody asks you where you live. So I was looking at this and saying, founded in 1982, why then? Why not, 1957? And I found out that one of the galvanizing purposes of the Neighborhood Association turned out to be this crappy library, where even the cars are old that park in front of it. And in my limited research, I found that this was the very first flyer that went out that said, What do we do? You want to get involved? Here it is. Show up. And here's the first meeting right here. Saturday, September 25th, 10 a.m. Huh, nothing's changed, really, has it? And you'll see Bruce's name on there. And this is the first drawing that they did to figure out where to put the library. There are five sites that they were trying to choose from around the middle of the neighborhood, and here's the one they chose. Of course, it doesn't look like that anymore. Somebody put a library on top of that. But there were a lot of people who worked on it, including Alice Jenkins, who was also a librarian, come to think of it. Not at that time, though. She was retired. They started in 82, and a bunch of years went by before they actually got to open the library, 18 years, and then Alice was, of course, the first woman allowed to enter a library with a giant pair of scissors. And the whole idea behind the line was to read between the lines. I didn't make that up. But what else happened in this neighborhood association? Well, there was the get rid of the airport, right? Move it. And one of those people is here, Rick. Tell me who's in this picture. Okay, whatever Rick said. And this is the back of the t-shirt. This is an airplane landing in your backyard. And there's a book that says Aircraft Disasters of the 20th Century right there on the desk. And the pencils are perfect. That's right before everything explodes. Fear works. The airport's gone, but what do you do with the land that's sitting there? I mean, that's 700 acres. You can't just simply have an open piece of land, so 5,000 meetings later, you get this. The Mueller Development, which we used to call it Miller, didn't we? Wasn't that what we called it?
Miller.
Thank you for confirming that. Sorry, I accidentally put that in there. Okay, so anyway, all that led to what's next, which is the 51st Street reinvention, which is going to have sidewalks for babies, bike lanes, cars, trees in the middle of the street. It's going to slow down. There's going to be parking. It's going to be beautiful, all because of this organization here. So we got the library. We did the airport. What else did we do? Man, there's so much. I just put it to music.
Could have been a sailor, could have been a cook, a real life lover, could have been a book.
Yeah, clap for those you know. This kid is still stuck in the film.
Could have been a clock, as simple as a kettle, steady as a rock. I could be here and now. I would be, I should be, but how? I could have been but what are these things first? I could have been.
They're painting the bleachers there.
Oh, what are these things first?
This is the last It's My Park Day. Thank you, Shereen.
Could have been your statue, could have been your whole friend. A whole long lifetime could have been the end. I could be oh so true.
Yeah, just leave that right there.
I would be, I should be, through and through.
Yeah, it makes you want to go to the creek, doesn't it?
I could have been but what are these things first?
Thank you to all those people who did all those millions of hours to make the yards look good in 30 seconds.
But what are these things first?
Thank you, Ann Harp, for all the pictures. I want to live in this neighborhood. Actually, I live next door to this guy. He gets the last shot. He used to have giant trees in his front yard. Now look at it. This is where we make the news once in a while. We make our own news. We once went to Mars. Don't look now, you're being followed. This is the coming Bartholomew swimming pool. We swear, we're not kidding this time. And this is the lovely crossing guard.
Simple as a gutter, steady as a rock. I could be even here.
This is us winning first place. Neighborhood Association.
I would be, I should be.
This is high fashion. I wish I had one. This is Rick's dad being kicked out of the meeting for telling a dirty joke. I don't know who these people are. Luckily they have name tags. I was really proud when we elected our first African-American president. And America followed suit. Right, leaders, we are. These are people who have not yet started working. Thank you, Jeanette Swenson. And please join the Neighborhood Association now, twice or three times. That's it. I was up so far in the morning. I had 3 hours of sleep, but thank God it worked.